Good day everyone and welcome to my channel. We call it Sunday School 101 with myself, Tsego Fatso. And let me start by thanking you all for watching this video. So it is actually our second session and I'm so excited. On today's session, we are talking about early childhood education. By early childhood development or education, we are basically referring to children from birth up until the age of 8 years old. That is when they are in grade 3. Yes, so it's from birth up until the last grade or foundation phase. The Constitution of South Africa, where I live, has given each individual and children as well, they also have rights. I'll just note a few basic rights that are there for children. The first one, the children have a right to a name or nationality so that they have a belonging. The second one, they have a right to parental care or have a family, belong in a certain family. They also have a right to basic health. They must receive basic health. Those are their basic needs. They must receive basic education, basic social care. They must be protected from abuse and neglect. They must also be protected from exploitative labor practices. So it is due to this rights and many other reasons why I believe that we should regard early childhood development as one of the tools or factors that influences the learning or the development of a child. It is quite visible and also an unavoidable fact that many of South African children are born in conditions of poverty, are born in conditions of neglect, and it is these poor conditions that often lead to children having problems in learning. Their learning is delayed because of the conditions that they come from. So when we talk about ECD, I'll just refer to it as ECD from now on. We'll talk about ECD. We focus on the needs of the child and also the environment that the child find themselves in. In that way, when we focus on those two things, we are able to tell or to explain the behavior of the child and also be able to come up with different ways of support for parents and for the children as well. So basically, early childhood, like I've said, is from birth. So the very important and first participants here are the families of the child, the parents. They are the most important people in the child's life and also in the child's development. Also the broader community. The community, the things or the resources that the child is exposed to, they play an important part in the development of a child, because a child experiences or goes through different experiences, and those are the things that molds or shapes his behavior in different stages of his life. A brain of a normal human being is largely influenced or shaped in the early years of their stages. So early childhood is basically a stage whereby adults or parents are given a task to keep an eye on the things that their children are learning. So that could mean that the things that you are doing are the things that you are actually teaching your child, the things that you are saying, the manner in which you behave is also the way in which your child should behave. So you must take a closer look at their behavior, and also that will give you an opportunity to reflect on your own life as an adult and also as a role model. So in our discussion, we'll basically be looking at the life activities of a child and also try to identify some of the factors that may assist us to build or develop a child that is well functional. Children are they are just amazing learners. They learn so fast and they can learn so many things at a go, like simultaneously. They can do a lot of things. They can learn how to speak, they can learn how to crawl or walk, they can learn how to express themselves, and they can learn certain gestures all at the same time. That is children for you. They it's so funny that even though they do learn what we tell them, but in most cases, children do what they see us doing. So for them, it's this concept of monkey see, monkey do. Like, it is so remarkable how much this little minds of our children can take. We'll even be surprised. You'll find yourself saying something in passing, and then after 2 weeks, you'll hear your child saying the same thing. That is just how, and their minds, when they grasp something, they hold on to it, and they will know when to use it. They learn to talk, they learn to express themselves, and they just do all these things in at the same time, and it is just amazing. We cannot even explain it. So, like I've said, how we raise our children is how they are actually a reflection of us as their parents. There are various areas of growth and development that children should go through, and those are the most important areas that parents and professional caregivers and educators should always look out for in a child. The first one is the area of social and emotional. This one is tied to the behavior of the child, how the child behaves around certain people, and also how the child socializes with other people, how they relate to other people. Those are important. We are able to see if the child has social problems when around certain people or when around certain environment. Are they able to interact? The second one is language. The language, we have in our clinic cards, we have the explanations there of a child's growth. From this age, we know this is what the child should do. We know these are the words that the child should be able to speak. So we should be mindful of the language that the child knows at a certain stage in their lives. And we should learn to use concrete words when we are talking to our children, because there are these things, especially as I don't know about white communities, because I'm a black person. We would often try to use baby language to, I don't know if it is to soften the child or what, but, and those, we would use words that are not correct, that are not concrete, that are not right. And at the end of the day, we find our kids saying the same words, even when they are 8 years old or above. That when we were not using concrete words, it delays the development of the learner. So let us learn to use language and words that are correct. And also in terms of language, children learn very fast. Like I've said, they are very fast learners, so they can learn different languages at a go. So we must make sure that when we teach them these languages, we teach them the correct words, because once they grasp the language, there's no turning back. It is very difficult to turn back. Fine. The third one is movement. Obviously, when we are talking about movement, we are talking about the physique of the child. At age 3, is your child learning how to walk, or are they still crawling? If they're still crawling, what is the problem? Do you see anything? Do they have any physical impairments, or what is happening? Are they able to run like other children? Are they active? Are they taking part in activities that the children the same age as them are taking part in? The last one is cognitive. This one, it's the mind. It involves their thinking skills. It involves, like this one is school now. It involves problem solving. Those are some of the things that it involves also, maybe reading, writing, and also saying things orally. What do you see? What is it that you see in your environment that are able to tell you what they see? And also problem solving. If you are having some puzzles, or if you are having maybe we can talk about puzzles. Can they rearrange the puzzles back? At a certain age, of course, we have learning materials that we give them? Are they able to process the information that a child their age should be able to process? So those are some of the areas that we should look at as parents and also as educators. And also we should keep in mind that each child is unique. Learning is not in any even manner. It is not a straightforward process. It is a process that is irregular because we have different children with different needs. Even if the children are from the same family, don't expect them to be the same. So we should learn that we are not going to use the same checklist to measure the learning capabilities of all children, because learning varies from child to child. The concept of ECD is not only good or effective for helping parents to get relevant help for their children, but it is also good for the children as it gives them a sense of strong mindset. It gives them confidence. It also gives them determination. It makes them people who are determined in their learning. So having a strong foundation of understanding what education is and also the mindset of a child basically gives one a better idea of what they can do to make sure that the child flourish, or also to detect troubles if there are any problems or troubled behavior that the learner shows. Then we would detect very early and know what to do to eliminate that behavior. Early detection is a very important tool in this process of early childhood development, because it does not only assist in getting relevant help sooner, but also it gives one the opportunity to adjust to the needs of their children. According to me, if things were up to me, I would make it compulsory for children from the age of 3 to be registered in early learning centers. Because I believe that a parent alone can only do so much, but at least when you involve a range of professionals, especially from a young age, 3 years old, great areas, it's there, but at that stage the child has already developed. There are some things that are already instilled in the mind of that child. So from the age of 3, at least you place this learner at a better chance of developing a healthier mindset, because educators and professional caregivers in early learning centers, they are trained to help our children to develop an emotional vocabulary through what? Through different activities that they give them. There's a routine at school, you know, it is so nice. You'll find your child coming back, they have learned this, you know, every day. This is and something that a child does every day, it stays in here. So when they get that positivity, you know, they can put this task upon us parents, but most of us are working and we are not able to do this. So we would be leaving our children with grandparents or people who are just merely looking after them. So at least taking them to early childhood development would really help them, because they're not only there to be looked after, but they learn various skills as well. Trained people and educators, they are at a better chance actually of understanding the behavior of the child, especially if they understand the environment that this learner or this child comes from. They will then know how to adjust, and also they will know how to help in order to remediate the situation. So we have reached the end of our session for today. It was not as long as the first session, but be that as it may, I would like to believe that there are two or three pointers that one could have noted down while listening, and we could be able to use those pointers to enhance our ways of living and to also help our family members or just people in the community. We are living in an era whereby everything is evolving, and it is evolving very fast. Early childhood learning centers actually have always been there, but they were there firstly to look after the children. That was it. And as the years went by, they changed. No, let us introduce the learners to activities because they'll be going to school soon. So, and right now, they are even in the Department of Education, they have been introduced early learning development, to like we have grade R right now. They have been introduced. So everything is evolving. So we just need to get it correctly. We just need to work together. The most important thing is collaboration. Let us work together to get the foundation right so that tomorrow we have a generation of people, or a generation of leaders actually, who are conscious about their potential, who are conscious about their intelligence and also their talents. They know they are not a generation that says, because I am not an academic, then I'm less of a human being. Because I can't do this, then I'm less of a human being. We are grooming children who will be accountable for their actions tomorrow, because they have been taught from a very young age that it is important for you to take accountability for what you have done or for what you have said. We are grooming children who will be disciplined tomorrow, who will know that how they behave may have an influence on their children. So they'll be very conscious of how they behave around their children. So right now, I believe that we are starting a cycle that will bring about positivity or positive results at the end of the day. This is a seed. If we can have the foundation right from birth up until 8 years, that we have a child there that we can control, that we can tell anything, and then they do as we say. So if we can get that right, the platform right, the way we speak to our learner, to our children, the way we address them, we are getting there. We just need to get there correctly. So I hope that you guys enjoyed, except enjoying listening to my voice, you enjoyed the session. And can you please leave your comments? If you need clarity on anything, you can ask questions. If you need to help me with any information, you are welcome to do so. I would really love to hear your input. And thank you very much for taking your time to listen to me. Have a great week. I hope to see you again next time. May you have a great, great week ahead. Be blessed and stay safe.